Welcome everybody, so I am back and bringing you guys a new sort of response video. This is going to be in response to the Halo TV show that is coming out. Now, these are kind of my thoughts on what is going on with the Halo TV show. I know that they attempted to do a Halo film back in the day with Peter Jackson attached and a screenplay by Alex Garland, which eventually got, you know, thrown out the wayside because Microsoft kind of took away the funding for the film and they didn't want to cooperate with it. But now Steven Spielberg, this is his long-awaited Halo TV series that I think even myself is a little bit excited for. But, you know, there is some things that make me skeptical. Now that I see who they're casting everything for the roles, they didn't hire Steve Downs for the voice of Master Chief yet. I'm still hoping that they eventually do, and they do something similar to what, you know, they did for Star Wars and Darth Vader, where they kind of redub over the actor who plays him in the suit, just because I think that they could do that and make it really interesting. You know, Master Chief's voice in the Halo series is really iconic, especially since he's been the character since 1 through 5, and now with Halo Infinite coming out, he's gonna be the voice actor for that. And like, you can't replace Steve Downs. Like, even if you try, it still sounds a little bit weird. Like, while I liked Halo 4 Forward to Dawn, that TV show did really well, I still thought it was a little bit weird that they replaced Master Chief's voice and that they didn't do what they did with Star Wars and just dub it over his voice with, you know, Steve Downs' voice. But as long as this guy that they hired sounds like Steve Downs, I think it should be really interesting. They also recasted Jen Taylor's character, which honestly, I think Jen Taylor is a fine actor and actress. You know, she does really, really great in pretty much all the voice acting that she does, and I don't understand why they couldn't just CG her character in sort of motion capture, or, you know, sort of CG her in the computer, since for most of the video game she's a hologram anyway. Like, you don't really get to see her in the flesh unless she's Dr. Halsey is sort of the model for Cortana, and they're both played by Jen Taylor, so you'd think that they would want to hire sort of the voice actor for the games just because she's also iconic as Master Chief. Like, these two kind of go hand in hand. Don't know why they didn't do that, but maybe Jen Taylor just had too much going on and that she didn't want to do it, or they didn't really ask her to do it anyway. Another thing that kind of bothered me is who they got to play Sergeant Johnson in the Halo TV show. I think Sergeant Johnson should be played by someone like Samuel L. Jackson, just because Sam Jackson really does look the part of Sergeant Major Avery Johnson, who's an important role throughout 1 through 3 of the Halo series. And I hear that there's rumors that they're going to bring him back for Halo Infinite, which I would be totally excited if they actually do that. But Sergeant Johnson is, you know, wisecracking, sort of badass. He's a stereotype of all those action hero characters that you see in countless other movies and stuff, but he still has really great one-liners and stuff, and I just feel like Sam Jackson could nail that role out of the park. But needless to say, Steven Spielberg didn't hire him for the role, so that makes me a little skeptical. I think that, you know, Lord Hood should be played by Ron Perlman, since Ron Perlman voice acted his character within the game and he did an exceptional job, especially with that cliffhanger ending at Halo 2. I just think that scene was pretty badass, especially the way that they handled the cutscene in the anniversary edition. You can't really replace Ron Perlman, and they tried to do that with Hellboy and that didn't work, so I definitely think that they should get Ron Perlman on board if they eventually do. But my best guess is that they hired somebody different, which kind of sucks in a way, but I could be mistaken since they didn't see all the cast members that they chose. But I know that they haven't, you know, really asked Steve Downs to do it, and I know that they kind of didn't ask for Jen Taylor to kind of reprise her role. So those are my overall thoughts of the Halo TV series. I still want this to be good. I still want this to be great, kind of like, you know, Game of Thrones or Spartacus or something like that on that caliber, because I think the Halo series definitely deserves a proper adaption, whether that be TV or film. I still think that a movie should come out at some point in time in my lifetime, just because the franchise still could use sort of a video game adaption into film. And I think a lot of people that are not gamers would go see it, and a lot of people that are gamers would go watch it just because it's Halo. But, you know, those are my thoughts and opinions on the Halo TV series. Like I said, you know, Steven Spielberg's my favorite film director of all time, and he worked with George Lucas, so I kind of have to give him the benefit of the doubt just because this is a project that he's kind of wanted to work on for a long time. And I know that he stated that he is a gamer and has played video games, so I think he's probably played Halo, if not as much times as me. And I'm huge, huge fan of the Halo franchise. Like, anybody who knows me knows that I'm a huge fan of that series, especially since on my other channel, I do play Halo a lot on that and upload Halo content. I still have beat Halo Combat Evolved on that channel, but no, that is neither here nor there. But yeah, those are just my short little thoughts on the Halo TV series by Showtime. Leave your comments in the comment section below of who you think should be cast in the Halo TV series, if you think I'm right in terms of who I think should be cast within the Halo TV series. And as always, guys, rate, comment, subscribe. I'll see you in the next video. Peace.